speaking of, here at the band Chemical Straitjacket. How you guys doing today?
Good, good. Yeah. Yeah.
Awesome. Want to tell us a little about the band for anyone who doesn't know?
Industrial rock band. We were formed 2 years ago. That would be what year?
What year is this?
2017. 2017.
Yeah.
Actually, Mike and I hadn't seen each other. Three of us grew up together. Mike and I hadn't seen each other for many years, almost 20, right? And then I came to see your indie rock band, and we had a few drinks, and we were like, you know what? Because we did industrial rock back in 1989, 90, and we felt like industrial now is very EDM, it's very techno, and we missed, you know, the Revco vibe, the Wax Trax vibe, and after a couple of drinks, he convinced me to start writing music and do it in that old style.
That's awesome.
Here we are.
That's awesome. Now, tonight's the CD release party, right?
Well, yes. And it's supposed to be the CD release party.
The CD reveal.
Yes, the CD reveal.
It's on the way.
That's why we have a professional with us.
Yes.
Meet John Bechtel of Ministry, who produced our new album, Rich of Things, which we're very proud of. But we hope to have CDs in hand tonight, but it didn't happen. We are in negotiations with something good. So,
so it's coming soon.
Yes, yes. But it delayed things. But yeah, it's coming.
How many albums do you guys have?
Well, we have our debut, then we did a remix album, and this is our second proper album.
Okay.
And trust me, I'm already working that.
Negotiating.
Now tonight, is this just one show, or do you do a little tour?
It was just, we have this show, we're going to open for Scold, and then we're also going to play the Steve
Con.
Oh yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, we'll get that.
That's anything like the Dark Side.
That was, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah,
awesome.
We went down there that one
night. Yeah,
that was good.
Yeah.
Good people run that too. It's very, very nice. Nice show. Then hopefully after we get this stuff settled and we get the release out, then we'll look at a proper tour.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Now, what are some of your singles and songs that people look up?
It seems like everybody loves House Upon the Hill from the debut. You know, that's probably the main track. If you want to look us up, look up House Upon the Hill by Chemical Straitjacket. So we've got to go
for Dress to Kill.
There is a proper video for Dress to Kill from the debut also, which is, I think that song probably catches our sound the most.
Sets
the tone. If you like Dress to Kill, you'll like us. The Apothecary from the debut. But what about, what's our most powerful tracks from Rich of Things, do you think?
I think it's real.
The only thing that's real. That was good tonight. Yeah,
we have a whole arsenal ready to go.
Yeah, JB to us, and JB was looking to produce, right, and start getting down that road, and I think we had about a 2-month courtship.
Yeah, we talked, and he sent me some stuff, and whenever I'm going to produce something, I listen to the music and try to understand, you know, where they're going with it, what they're trying to do. I don't come at it like, oh, you need to just like start all over, and you need to do this, and do that. That's not the kind of producer I am. So I heard, you know, definitely strong, you know, talent there.
Sort of potential.
Just felt that, you know, yeah, with just a little bit of help, these guys would sound really great. So.
And it changed everything, because really the debut was pretty much made in, mostly in my laundry room, to be honest. Mike's guitars got added at a studio, but it was mostly made in my laundry room. And it was funny, because the first call I got from JB, I actually first couldn't believe it, but it was John Beck from the ministry. I thought one of these guys was fucking with me. But when I was convinced that it was him, he said, I'd like to work with you if you are willing to abandon that lo-fi sound. And I was like,
the laundry room sound.
Yeah. I was like, you mean the laundry room sound? Yeah, man. I'll look at the down right now.
No problem, no problem. That's not a deal breaker.
Yeah. What did I say?
It's still, the laundry room is still there, it's written, because there's some magic in that laundry room. Yes, but then we take it to JB's amazing studio. That place is great. The vibe, the energy, and I mean, working with him was not just a producer, he's a multi-instrumentalist. He added bass lines, and he tweaked the synths, and I mean, it's amazing. It's
rearranged all nightclubs.
Just broadened it out.
We can't wait for you to hear it.
Yes.
So where do you see the band in like 5 years from now?
Probably in this.